Hello everyone, welcome to the Geek Cupboard. I am Penge and this is Project Highrise, and it's the Penge Spire and it's almost finished. Last time out we came to the realisation that even though I can build 15,000 tiles worth of stuff, 15,000 tiles isn't enough to actually fill up every single bit of space in the tower. So that is it. This, what is there now, is 15,000 tiles worth of stuff, of space to build in. And these are the only vacant bits left. So in the whole of the tower now, it's the spiry, pointy, not that pointy, kind of going to a blunt bit at the top. That's all that's left. So yes, last time when I left, I was sorting out services and things. So yeah, it's full. It's all full. Very full of services. And I think I have realised why I have had such problems with services, particularly security services and things like that, all of a sudden flagging up and saying, right, no, it's not enough. I also did have someone move out, which was a problem. Someone moved out, so there wasn't enough auditors, and they just moved out. One of these offices along here, one of the big ones along here somewhere, which was a bit annoying because I didn't have anywhere to put any auditors. So a few services have gone onto this floor. So my logic for this is, people will come up here, diddly dolly do, they'll walk along here and get in this lift and go up to the exciting stuff. So this is all going to be fun stuff, shops and whatever, and restaurants, and there will be some big apartments and there'll be art and blah blah blah, lovely things. But yes, why are the services failing? Let's take a look at our hyper-advanced computertron. Yes, hello Ada System 360. Let's have a look at the services report. Okay, looks fine, doesn't it? So the eagle-eyed amongst you might already be thinking, hang on a minute, that doesn't make any sense, but let's just order it by calls. So let's have a look at the most popular ones. So this says, how many service calls have been placed, which is a curious, actually the tense is slightly wrong. How many service calls have been placed by your tenants yesterday? I would rather say were placed by your tenants yesterday, but okay. So that's how many I've got. So I have 26 couriers, and allegedly yesterday the couriers took 851 calls. So they succeeded. How many of those service calls have been fulfilled successfully? 848. So you go, yeah, so maybe there's three short. So fail is going to be three. How many of those service calls were not fulfilled because the service unit is too busy or missing? Zero. So you go, okay. Security took 609 calls and successfully handled 699 calls. They also failed one, which doesn't make any sense. That does not compute. So they took 90 more calls, they dealt with successfully 90 more calls than they received, and then they also failed one. And this doesn't, so janitors, 580, 579 they succeeded with, yet they failed none. So one call just vanished into the ether, and the handyman have been particularly exceptional, dealing with 120, successfully dealing with 120 more incidents than they actually got called about, which is good. But yes, yeah, so these are the ones that keep going wrong. So computer and IT, even though they took 337 calls and successfully dealt with 371 calls, they allegedly failed to deal with 18 calls, which doesn't make any sense. So I assume there is a bug somewhere within this. I don't know when it started happening. I don't know if it's the scale of people, if the amount of offices and people and whatever in there has triggered something to go wrong. But yeah, there is clearly a problem with the service provisioning and the numbers and such like, because I haven't even been around all of them, but I don't think any of them add up correctly. I don't think it works properly. Even the first one, I've got one flower thingamabobber, one flower organizer, decorator, whatever it is. One person that deals with flowers, they took 10 calls. They successfully handled 19 of those 10 calls and yet failed to deal with 8 of the 10 calls, even though they successfully dealt with 19 of the calls. And there's a pointy downwards arrow. So yeah, that is why these keep coming up. So I think I was forever fighting a losing battle. And now I know that, I don't feel so bad. It wasn't my own kind of poor planning. It would also explain why, after having a fixed amount of offices for a long time, all of a sudden it kept going, more security services, more security services, more couriers, more print shops, more corporate communication services, more of everything, when, you know, nothing had changed. Everything was the same. So that would explain why. I assume it is a bug. But on account of the fact I don't want people to leave, I filled up the basement with things. So the basement is now full of useful services, which people wanted at the time, even though it might be hooky and wrong. So yeah, people still want IT services, but they don't. But the maths is leading it to think it does, which is a little bit strange. In come all the people. No, some people are coming in and some people are going out. So yes, everything is full. The basement is full. There is no room. There's not a single square of space to build in the basement. Along here somewhere, I took some lifts out. This floor sacrificed the lift so I could fit some more services in. There's some more power things down there and down here. Yeah, the basement has no more room. It is jam-packed capacity. And I have been through every floor. So along here, these were empty. So along this bit here, there were some empty sections of three. So where there was not a payphone on that floor, which there were not on any of the bits, I think it had other stuff in, shoe shines at the end, but there were no payphones. So I put a payphone in to use two of the gaps up, and then a little lovely work of art, sort of kind of alternating as it goes up, 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 up. So all to there, oh, that went a bit wrong with the alternating, but whatever, it doesn't really matter. So there's payphones, next some art. So you could go and see this beautiful thing. You could go and see this wondrous kind of stalk art thingy and then ring someone about it and tell them how beautiful it was using an old-fashioned yoldy payphoney. So I've been through every bit of every floor. I've gone through gone across it like this, sending my eyes funny. And going all the way up, all the way up. And I cannot see a single unused space in the whole of this tower now, until we get to the spiry pointy bit at the top, which is the only bit left we need to work on. So yeah, I can't see anything. There's no gaps. I am very confident that as of here, so yes, there's gaps there, but that's the spiry bit. So here, down is full. I'm not going to get anything else in there. So it's time to basically work on this bit. So the plan would be to put some shops in. I need to put three loft apartments in because I want to sort that contract out, because then that will go away. And I think, I would assume, that is the last contract that I will have to do. Hurrah. However, I'm also going to put shops and things up here and restaurants and fill it with other things. So like maybe some more offices or some apartments or whatever, because I'm not going to fill all that with shops. And the risk of putting shops in is that the other shops then start going, oh, regular customers are going elsewhere. And then they all leave, which is desperately irritating. Let's be honest. It's very, very annoying that they just suddenly give up and go, right, no, so our customers are going elsewhere, even though we hardly pay any rent. And we've got loads of customers. We make an absolute bomb every day. Some of our customers are going elsewhere, so yeah. And then out they go. It's a little bit tiresome. I also just realised I need to look at how many of these I've got. 1, 3, 4, 7, 9, 10. So I've got capacity for 10 more janitor cupboards as well, which is quite nice. So I must remember to include them if at all possible. And then, yes, the top floor. There's a plan for the top floor, which is very exciting. So yeah, I think I touched on this before and then span off nattering about something else. I envisage that the people are going to come up in this lift. Doodle-loo-loo, the people that are going to go to the spire. And they're going to walk along here, doodle-loo-loo-loo, and get in this lift. So this bit here has good sort of through traffic. So I was thinking of putting a shop. So I was going to put a luxury goods store there, and then possibly put a smaller shop there, and then see what's left, see what space there is. In fact, how much space would there be? So that is the same width as the thing above it. The little shop is there, and that leaves, what's that, six. A space of six. What can fit in six? Can a medium restaurant fit in six? No, it cannot. It definitely can't. It's 8, which is a little bit tedious, isn't it? Can we put a large restaurant in and one of the... No, we can't do that either. A gourmet restaurant and the other thing. Right, so the gourmet restaurant sticks out 2 over the side of there. So if we did that and that, that would leave 4. So I could, in theory, put an office there, which is a bit rubbish. Oh, no, I could put a coffee shop or something there, couldn't I? That might be quite good. So let's do that, shall we? So a luxury goods store there, next to a gourmet restaurant, which is there, next to a little tiny coffee shop, which is there. So a cafe. So just that, coffee and breakfast, you'll do, because these ones, coffee and lunch, for some reason pay more. Coffee and lunch pay more. I don't really know why. And they need water. So why coffee magically produces coffee drinks without the need for water? It just needs electric. They just plug you in. They don't need caffeine. They just use literal electricity and jab wires into your head. So yeah, we'll have Y coffee. We'll have the electrocutors. And we shall drop your rent. You can pay $6 a day. $6 per day is all you are paying. Right, and next to them, there can be a jeweler's. So let's have Legar and Stein Fine Gems. Yes, and you can pay significantly less. And for our poshy restaurant, now, I wanted to tell you which ones I've got. Where's restaurants? Is there a restaurants one? Tenant overview? Where's for food? Where's a foodie one? There isn't. Oh, I wanted one that told me what the breakdown of my restaurants was. If I had 4 Chinese restaurants and 1 Indian, I would put an Indian restaurant in. But I don't think that's in there, is it? That's services, population report, no. Population feedback. Oh, right, okay. It's dirty and the line is long and people want coffee. There are no dinner spots in this building. There bloody are! There's loads of dinner spots, you miserable gimps. Okay. It doesn't tell me, so I'm just going to have to kind of a tenant listing. Oh dear, this is taking a long time to produce. Come on, Ada/360. That's no bloody use at all. Rent 0. Oh, you're the construction office, that's why. Who pays the most? Oh, I'm not going to do that. The luxury lofts. That's quite right, as they should. You're living in a giant loft in the top of a massive tower. Okay, there's no way to determine what we've got and what we haven't. So let's put in a Chinese. Why not? Let's have the Qian restaurant or the Qian kitchen. Oh, the agony of choice. Isn't Qian what my city is called in the Civilization 6 One City Challenge playthrough? Obvious plug that I'm playing right now as well. How intriguing. Yes, we'll have the restaurant named version rather than the whatever the other one was. And we'll drop your thing as well. Right, so now that row is completed. So the only thing it doesn't have is a little janitor cupboard. So they will have to come up there for those 3 restaurants a little bit more often. That row is done. Okay, lofts. We need 3 of these in. Now, I'm tempted to just go loft, loft, loft. Just put them in, get them done. So 1, 2, 3. Is it worth putting a 4th in? Maybe, can I fit 5? In theory, I could fit 6 in, which is quite cool. And that uses up a big chunk of the space, which is fine. I'm not too fussed about using the space. So, yes, yes, yes. Now, you'll notice that I'm playing this on slow speed because I'm going to get... I suspect not everyone is going to stay in this tower whilst I'm working on the pointy, spiry bit at the top. I think people are going to leave because people are going to go, there's not enough services. For some reason, we need 1 IT man for every single person in the whole building. So, yeah, I think people might leave, possibly, which is not ideal, but there you go. That's what happens. Right, what can we do with some of this other space then? So those lofts, are they going to be happy living next door? Oh, I don't really want one there, actually, because I was going to put... Hang on, pause it. Here we go. Captain Moron thinking about it now. Yeah, just there. I was going to put a restaurant just there and then have the bins over that side. But if I evict them, how much is that? 3 grand minus 4 prestige. You know what? Okay. It doesn't really make any difference now. So let's do that. Well, I love the way it's like, do you want to evict the tenant? No one's moved in yet. It's not even built. How can I evict something that's not a thing? They're not even there. Okay, so we're going to put a restaurant there and bins just there. So what else can we put next to these? Do we want to fill these up with sort of apartment-y type things? Or do we want to put shops and things next to them? Should I put them on that side? And had... because people are going to be walking through them to the shops, aren't they? Oh, did I just make a terribly hasty decision? A really stupid decision. Stupid. Oh, that fits quite nicely there. So let's put a retail shop, a double floor shop thing there. That fills that space rather excellently. And let's have a fancy grocery store. Let's have Draper's original store. And because there is a little tiny gap of one, let's see, look. They're cross. They're all cross. They're going to move out. Yeah, let's get rid of that then. Let's put in a tiny piece of art. Small art. Let's have the painting of the rude lady. There we go. Painting of a rude lady fills that gap nicely. So yeah, I need to figure out what can go up here now. And how many bays have I got left as well at the bottom for shops? So I have, when we scroll down the tower, 4 bays. So I can have 4 more shops and that is it. Okay, that is intriguing, isn't it? So I can only have 4 more shops. So I wanted a shop along here somewhere. And I wanted, if I press the right button, it would help. A posh shop, just there. And then I was going to drop a bit of art in. Let's have a clear bit and let's have a little statue-y thingy. Let's have the dude's head. There we go. Terrible pub. You, sort of bust of, presumably Mozart. It's a bit weird they're all the same. People are coming along going, it looks familiar, that piece of art. I swear there was one on floor 8 down by the bins. So yeah, there might have been one of those. Anyway, moving on. And a fine art store at the top. Let's get the Violet and Stag Gallery. That sounds good. Yeah, you'll do. Bang. Okay, so there's... That is a shop. Done. At the top. Now, we need to figure out what we want to do with these then. So do I want to put restaurants in? Not really. Janitor cupboards, actually. Let's see if we can drop a few of those in. There. Broom closet things. Yay! There we go. Loft life is complete. I've got $8,000. Any more contracts? Nope. I am done. No more contracts are available. Wow. I've finished. I've done the contracts. Right, well, let's put one there because that fits quite nicely in that little gap. So that's convenient. That's good. That fills in that gap, and that is rather handy. They're all removing the detritus that they left behind. Right, let's drop their rent because they're going to be complaining about this restaurant on here in a minute. Also, yes, bins. They're going to need bins. Bins on that floor. So that and recycling. Okay, big restaurant going in just there. So let's put in, at the top of here, a family restaurant. Why not? Gary's. See, they moved out before, though, the family restaurants. We've got a sports bar at the top. That's quite cool. Marie's Bar and Grill, or McCarthy's. That sounds good. Yeah. So I'll nip down McCarthy's. Okay, there's a space of 4. What can we do with some of this space? Well, that space of 1 is going to have to be art because nothing fits in a 1 space. Nothing goes in there. So let's drop in a picture of that. Right. So that's that done. Along here, I suspect I might need to put in some more of these. Can I fit another one of... Not those, you gimp. One of those in, and it leaves a gap of 1 at the edge. Ooh, I could do that, or I could put in... That leaves 1 at the edge, but that's 2 separate apartments. I'd rather drop one of those in, because it uses the space quite nicely. Yeah, a large duplex apartment. Thank you very much. Plop that in and you can have a bit of art. You can have the weird painting of the kind of crazy mountains. Good. There. What can we fit in there that isn't terrible? There. That. Yeah. Did put that in. Yeah, luxury apartment. Oh no, these people are going to be expecting bins and stuff, aren't they? Oh no, there aren't any bins. There aren't any bins. You're going to have to use the lift and go up and down a floor. What a terrible hardship you have in your life. Okay. They're going to get annoyed. We're going to need to do this very quickly. Let's pause. Let's just pause time for a second. So, yeah, they're going to complain that there are no bins, which isn't brilliant because they might move out if there's no bins. Because, yeah, they're expecting bins. Could not dispose of our recycling or our trash. Yeah, just say need them on this floor. Which floor are you on? Or do you need them on all the floors? So they'll be all right. They'll be fine. But these ones here and these ones here are not going to be so fine. Right, okay. Again, a rash decision. Let's take you out. Yes, I need two prestige. Don't care. So drop them out. That's fine. We'll put the bins along there, I suspect. So, and then these guys, the bins can just go next to them just here. Yeah, why not? There's only bins. Okay. Or should the bins go on this side? The bins can just go down the side. Let's just put them down the edge. Yeah, bins, 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 bins. Loads of bloody bins. I don't know which floor they're supposed to be on, so yeah, that'll do. Definitely not that though. Recycling, 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 recycling. It's important. Right, good. Okay, so that's bins done. And now we have another slightly tedious gap. So let's, surprise, surprise everyone, let's put the weirdy art thing in, the weird jiggity jaggity shape thing. Right, so that's that done. Janitor cupboard. Oh yeah, one would fit just there quite nicely. Yeah, okay, let's do that. So let's pop a janitor cupboard in. I love janitor cupboards. Love them. I love you guys, janitors. You're the real people who keep this building working. Right, let's speed time on. Let's drop their rent to hardly anything. $38 a day. Given that it costs an absolute flipping fortune to have you in there just so you can have your cable telly, I think you're doing quite well, McCarthy's Bar. Ooh. Yes, yeah, still unhappy people here. Could not dispose of our bin. Oh yeah, they haven't got bins either. Ooh, that could be an issue later on, couldn't it? That could be a problem. Yeah, they can't put their rubbish away, which is not great, to be honest. It's not very convenient at all. Okay, right. Well, the builder people can still work on that. If they're doing anything. Where are the builder people? Come on, builder people. How much are they going to make today, then? So they've made 150. So again, they should be fairly happy. Right, someone has moved out. Let's have a look. Show me. Okay. Where? Show me. Where? Your tenants are moving out. Show me. I know they moved out. I evicted them. Oh, in here. Our employees seem unhappy here. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean for you to be unhappy. Employees of Foundation Tax Offices. Oh, gotcha. Yeah, bye. Bye, tax man. Bye-bye. Cheerio now. So yes, I need to be wary of this, because obviously now there is a space. Oh my god, in they come. Crikey. You're all bored or something? Right, let's put in some legal people. Let's put in the Bonnie Barlow Law Group. Yeah, I like her. She sounds good. Bonnie Barlow. Right, and back at the top we go. Diddly diddly do. Taking forever. Yeah, see, look. Our regular customers are going elsewhere. Even though we're making it, we don't pay any rent. Even though we pay no rent. At all, and we make lots of money. We have 35, we have 211 regulars. Our regular customers are going elsewhere. Not the end of the world, is it really? Not the end of the world. All right, you can do that. Okay, that unit's getting a bit run down. Oh, yeah, see, they're all run down there. Look, yeah, and you've only been open about a day, but already you're run down. I see, like that, is it? Yeah, right, okay. All those bins are in. It's all looking good. It's all fine. Right, we're going to pause it because it's not going as well as I want. Okay. This is a good space here to put a common area. because these are residents and they can use the common areas. So that's good. It's a nice legitimate use of the space. I might also put one just there because, again, they're residents and they have a common area, which is good. So along here, these two floors are going to need bins. So let's pop the bins in. Let's put that like that and put the recycle bins next to them. So what can fit in this gap? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Can we fit that in? No. Can we fit a small one in? Yes, we can. Okay, well, let's do that. Let's lift our one a bit. There we go. Luxury studio. Thank you very much. And then, yes, we've got another gap. That's a bit annoying if I'd have moved that over. I could have had a proper bigger bit of art, but never mind. So, yes, let's drop some art in. Let's have statue-y thingies or whatever they're called. What are they called? Sculptures. That would be the bean. A weirdy wiggly thing and a stalk thing. There we go. What can we put on this floor? Can we have one of those there? Oh, yes, we can. That fits very nicely, doesn't it? Luxury apartment. Thank you. And nothing else will fit. A normal apartment will fit there. So we'll have a luxury studio. So yeah, we might as well fill these up. Because yeah, I can't put too many shops and restaurants in. Because as we can see, you build one restaurant and suddenly everyone is outraged saying, right, I'm not staying here ever. Wow, and the tax people are certainly not happy. Are you thinking of leaving as well? Eagle tax offices. The tenant is considering moving out. All right, stay. Please stay. You can stay here for free. The admission's free. Step into the Penge Tower. Let's have a look at what else we can drop into these gaps. So, yeah, it doesn't fit. That fits there quite nicely. So let's drop one of those in. Can we drop that in there? Yes, and they've got bins and things, which is nice. Can we drop a janitor cupboard just there and then put some art or something to fill that gap? So let's do that. So storage, it's weird that it comes up under storage, but okay, not a problem. So yep, and some monstrous wallpaper and then the weird thing there. Let's drop that in just there. Right, okay, this gap here, is it big enough for something like a coffee shop or something? Or is that just going to irritate everybody? I don't know if that's just going to annoy people. What about a little store? A small store would go quite nicely just there. There we go. And we can put in something like a flower shop. So I don't think we've got many flower shops. And these people might want their flowers, which is nice because they've got an apartment. They might want some lovely flowers to go into their gigantic buildings. Look at those. Vast and all the same. And you're all standing by your front doors. Are you all looking through the keyhole? Howard works at the dry cleaners. Laura works at the tailor. Earl works at the dry cleaners. Anthony works at the dry cleaners. And Sherry works at the dry cleaners. They all just stood in these houses. Why are they just stood there? I don't really know. Okay, good. Right, so let's hurry things along. And let's get those things built. Oh yeah, what are my worker people doing? I bet they're clearing out all the rubbish, aren't they? Right, so someone else has moved out. Right, this is ridiculous. So they moved out, even though our employees seem unhappy here. Oh, that's fair enough, I suppose. I might put an office in there then, because, and then just fill it up with whatever, a big office and a small office, or two mediums or something. Oh, goodness me, and someone else has moved out. Yeah, that big office moved out. I don't know why they're so bothered, because no one would be getting off on that floor. There'd be foot traffic if that was the floor that everyone was getting off on, but they're not. I don't really understand that, but okay, fine. This floor looks very knackered, doesn't it? Look at that. Big holes in it there. What's going on? Big bits. Units worn down. Come on, maintenance people. Work. Right. So these places are absolutely raking it in. So that place has made a lot of money. What about this place? They need more recycling bins on that floor. Yes, I know. Okay, let's take one of these out. Let's take out you. Whatever, I don't care anymore. There we go. Right, speed time on. I need to remember to go and fill in the gaps that I've already had from stuff from people leaving and moving out. So yeah, so we'll try and get the buildy men in. Come on, buildy people, let's do this. Wherever you might be. Oh my goodness, more people moving out. Yeah, it's not going very well all of a sudden now. As soon as the tower becomes big, everyone is getting very unhappy and wanting to move out. Okay, I make a lot of money. Let's adjust our finances, because I don't need all that money anymore. For offices, let's go to 60%. Yeah, guys, come on. 60% less. Oh, yeah, that one went straight away. So they basically went, yes, yes, I'm with you. I actually like it here. After, funnily enough, now that I don't pay much to stay here, I think it's brilliant. So yeah, I need to hurry this along, really. Where were the people that moved out? God, where is it? Where are the blank spaces? I thought it was down here somewhere. But clearly it isn't. There's a sad face. There's a cross face there. So I thought it was along here. Okay. There! Oh, they still haven't cleared that one then. Okay, right. Well, we'll have to sort that out at a later date. Right here, let's put in... yeah, I'm not going to put in a restaurant because I'll just move out because they're idiots. Oh, good. Oh, good. One shy. Who'd have thought? And a finance office and Wonder London can move in. And then you can have a picture next to you, Wonder of London. You can have the picture of the naughty lady. There we go. The picture of the naughty lady is in place to keep the Wonder London people entertained. Right. What's going on? What has been happening since I've been dealing with everyone bloody moving out? Because everyone's all grumpy all of a sudden. Now that our tower's good. Okay, are they making any money at all? Oh my goodness, the Violet and Stag Gallery is making an awful lot of money. 87 customers yesterday. Blimeys. Okay. Right, that's a surprise. Right, big restaurants don't fit in there, do they, anymore? So we can't fit any big restaurants in. The gourmet restaurants, however, one of them would fit just there. And it would have bins on the floor. So let's put a gourmet restaurant in and drop... bins in either side. So the no wrong button, they'll have to go there, and the recycle bin will have to go on that side. Okay, who do we want to move in here? Let's have a French restaurant. Let's have the Bistro Achille. In fact, no, there's an Indian restaurant on the ground floor, so if we put one at the top, that'll work quite well, won't it? A nice balanced approach sort of thing. What can we do with these? There's not much we can do with these. A gap. 4. Could fit an office in, but that would look slightly weird. I don't really want to put an office in. Not a shop. I was thinking one of those. A little coffee shop might fit there. For people that are going up. Yeah, you know what? That'll do. Cafes. Yeah, bakery. Alice's Bakery. Over here, I don't really know what to put in. What about... can people use them? Tower dwellers. So yeah, we'll use these if they're on the same floor as our office or apartment. So if I put a common room in, which is good, and then a payphone, that fills that up very nicely. That's rather good. Okay, let's put another little tiny apartment in just there. Let's decorate them. Luxury, luxury, luxury. Right, there's a gap of 1 there, which is all getting a little bit tedious, but I suppose that's what will come from when you have a pointy, misshapen bit at the top. Let's drop in the weirdy picture of the scribbly lines. Okay, what can we do with these gaps then? What can we do with that? We could have... we've got a common area. What else... these offer shoe shine is for tower dwellers, so that's anybody, and that's office workers. Right, so that's no use, but that is tower dwellers, so in theory could put one of those in and one of those there. It's a little bit cheaty, but nothing else fits. They're too big now, yeah, by 1 square, so nothing else really fits in there. So unless we put a load of art, which I don't want to do right now. So there's a common area we could put on there. Because there isn't one on that floor. Yeah, let's do that, and then let's press the right button now. Let's have a shoe shine. Do I want to do a shoe shine? No. Right, that floor can have a payphone like that. And that floor can have a payphone next to the electrical stuff. And then just there, yes, this is a bit better, isn't it? Wallpaper. We can have a bit of medium art for a change instead of the crappy art. Let's have that. Hey, it does annoy me that that's not centered. It does great on the nerves. Just put it in the middle. It's also a bit weird that you can't move art, medium abstract landscape. You can't move art once it's down. You can't get that picture and put it somewhere else. Most other things in this game, I understand. If I built an apartment, I can't just go, I'm going to move that apartment somewhere else and just do it easily. However, a picture is on a hook on a wall. Can I not just unhook the picture from the wall and move it? I would have thought that would have been a thing that I could do. But clearly that is not a thing that anyone can do. Right, that's there, so I can put the bins in. So trash, just here. Let's put two bins in and a recycly thing, because that uses that space quite nicely, and there's various things going on. Why is this so tired? Oh, it's already scheduled. Okay, good. Okay, here. This needs something in it. Did it have an office in it before? I think it rather did. Right, okay. Yeah, you can have your finance office, and you can be here for free. No cost. No charge, everybody. No charge. That whole floor is utterly dilapidated. That's knackered, and that office is knackered. Going on that floor? Is there a problem with the ventilation or something? Is everything just becoming damp and mouldy? How grim. Okay, so they've moved in. Have they cleared out that office yet? Yes, they have. Okay, right, in you come, sirs. Apologies, a minor Whaley Charbase interruption there, but we are back. So yes, this place was empty and now it is not. Bedrock investigation are there. Let's drop their thing because I'm kind. And I don't think anyone else did move out, did they? I don't think. Some people had some red sort of angry faces, but I don't think anyone actually did leave. I'm fairly certain I can't see any empty bits. I can't see anything anyway. Nothing is immediately obvious, and they do sort of stick out because there's obviously nothing in there. So I can't see a vacant space where there should be an office, and there is not. So all the apartments are still in. So just did a quick glance, so sort of there across, so yeah, everything is still in, yeah, everyone still seems to be there now, so yeah, so it's all full again, with some minor changes. They've got an office now rather than a restaurant, which is fine, because then these restaurants up here can't whinge about it too much. My little plan for this is working rather well, but they are getting absolutely swamped. They made $8,000 yesterday. That's rather a lot of money, isn't it? Right, let's speed that up and you can build some bins. And hopefully that will make those people happier, because you need to put your rubbish somewhere. Come on, build quicker, dudes. Yes, right, okay, they've got bins in. They cannot complain anymore. So yeah, they can complain now because, yeah, that they couldn't dispose of the recycling yesterday. And that is true. But now you will be able to. You're on the top floor of a building. Can you not just, you know, check out the windows? Fellas, just open your windows quietly. Just lob it out. No one will know. Well, as long as you don't label it or anything. As long as you don't have very bespoke rubbish, you'll be fine. Where are my maintenance men? Seriously. Come on, maintenance men. Get these things done. Okay, how many more shop things have I got left? Because I want to put some more shop. Two. So I might as well try, if I can, and put two more shops in. Can I fit two shops in? Let's have a look. Well, we'd certainly be able to fit two of those in. But it'd be nice if you could fit one of those in. There's a gap of one next to it, though, which is a little bit tedious. All right, what about one there? Which is good. What do we want? I don't want electronics. A department store. Let's put BY Thompson's at the top. A slightly annoying arty thing required there. Small art, let's drop that in. And here can be a janitor cupboard, because that will help keep it clean. So now I've only got this left. So I've got one shop. So I've got the space for one shop, which is a luxury goods store. So let's drop that in. Or should we put that there? Because I'm thinking luxury goods store, a little cafe, which will have a gap. So we'll put some art or something next to the luxury goods store. And then on this floor, have a sort of slightly a medium restaurant. And I don't know what can go just there. What can go there on a space of five when we're not actually doing anything with it? I do not know. What can we put there? Well, let's do that floor first. Let's put in just there. Let's put in the little cafe like that. Oh, it could be a food court, couldn't it? That's it. That's a good idea. Food court thing there. Coffee shop there with a medium restaurant next to it. So that'll do. So let's have gourmet rolls. Seeing as we're at the top of the building, gourmet rolls there. And a coffee place there, so a cafe. Let's have the Boulangerie de Paris. Yes, that there, please. And then the little luxury goods store can drop in just there with a tiny bit of space for a beautiful statue-y thingy, a sculpture of a whirly thing. I don't know what that's supposed to be. A bit of metal after a car crash or something. I don't really know. And yes, can we fit a medium restaurant in? Yes, we can. And that will also have... let's put a picture up. And it can be the picture of the naughty lady. There we go. So what kind of thing here do I want? A pizza place. Yes, I haven't got many of those, I don't think. Sharp's Family Pizzeria. I don't know how you say that. And what do I want near the top? Fine wine? Next to the sandwich shop? I don't know. Rare and antique books. I think I've already got a couple of those. I don't think I've got many cosmetics boutiques. That'd be quite cool. Go to the top and get your face done and stuff. So that is full, apart from the top. The top floor is yet to be done. So, we need to top off. See, look, they're complaining now. They're like, bro, our regular customers are going somewhere else. It's like, yes, they are going somewhere else, but they will come back. In fact, let me study this. You have 165 regulars. That's quite a lot of regular customers. So I wouldn't worry too much, given that you didn't pay much rent anyway, you pay zero now. You make quite a lot of money and you don't pay any rent or hardly any rent. I don't think you need to stress too much, you silly people. Nothing going on. I think power and electric and water wise, we are looking good. So gas 73, water 77, phone 78. Electricity 84 and cable TV, I imagine, is relatively low. Oh, it's about the same. With that in mind, I'm hoping these people don't move out and kind of ruin this moment. I think it's time we go and do the top. Let's speed on and see if they move out, actually. Let's give it a while and see if the red angry face goes away. And if it doesn't, we'll just put another shop, another one of those back in fairly quickly. Because otherwise then other officers will leave out. Because it's like, there's enough gourmet places to eat. So let's see if that works. Is it going to work? Oh, I'm losing 13 grand a day. Right, okay. I do need to sort that. Right, angry face is gone. So the fact they're not paying any wage, they're not paying any rent, helped. So this is it. It's full. It's full of relevant things as well. I've not just gone, right, 36 common areas, ding, 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 just, in a row to fill them in. I have tried my best to fill it in with useful stuff. So, there was a gap of two. So I gave them, these are sort of office-y things, aren't they? So I gave them a vending machine and that kind of thing. And, gaps of one you can't fill. But art is fine because art adds to prestige. So now, at the top, this is it. This is the final acts. There's nothing else that we can do. Can we adjust that yet, or is it still frozen? Because my office is locked for another 21.19 hours. I'm not so fussed. I've got over $2 million. I'm losing $13,000 a day. I could go and adjust the office rent rates back up a little bit if I could be bothered. I don't think I'm going to. Because the time, I have to wait to do it, and it's all a bit tedious. We know that it can be done, and we know that I think even if I up it to another 10%, if I up it to, what was it? If it works, yeah. If I put offices at 70%, I'm fairly sure that will be fine. So yeah, if I put retail and offices up 10% each, I think I would start making a profit. I don't think it's a particular niggling issue. So yeah, I think it might be time to go and complete this. Go and finish. Go and top the tower off with the final bits. Stuff that I have kept. I saw the size of these things and I kept them. For this very reason. So here we go. Let's spend some of our money. So, we've not got much in the way of large art. So, here we go. I can't put... It has to go on the ground floor. Hang on. Oh, no. Oh. Okay. Oh, yeah. Commission in place a large lobby mural by a famous artist for a significant prestige boost. Okay. I didn't do that. I didn't notice that until just then. Okay. Right, a change of plan. It's going to be full of medium art that you've seen elsewhere around the building, but never mind. So let's put some fountains and things in. So yeah, this is it. This is going to be the final bit. So let's put a ball fountain thing at each end. Like that, look. Ooh, fountains. And then, we can't put outdoor stuff on, can we? Plazas don't count, do they? Because they're not outside. Yeah, so it's just going to have to be medium art then. Okay, so let's put a cubey thing as you come up the stairs. Cubey thing. Let's put a big kind of Maui stone head thing there. So they're the two sculptures. If you notice, I split this 50-50. So this is wall for pictures. That was sort of, you know, the fact that it's got a fountain there doesn't really matter. That was supposed to be for the statue-y thing. The big statue-y thing that was supposed to go there. Whoops. Let's put some of these in, because everyone loves these. These are everyone's favourites. Oh, it's raining. Hang on. Right, I'm not having it raining when I'm finishing this game. I'm not having rain. Right, we're speeding it on until the rain stops. Right, here we go. The top of the tower is booming. This shop, maybe not so much, but the food places, look at it. People are going for a bit of pizza. They are making an absolute fortune. They haven't got bins. I completely forgot about bins. Never mind. That place is making a lot of money because, weirdly enough, they don't need bins. I don't know what they do with their rubbish. They must lob it out the window. That place, the lovely gourmet rolls, is making money. This place is making money. That place is making some money, not a lot. In fact, let's drop. You can be there for free. So this is it. Night time. It's midnight. It's gone midnight. The lovely, lovely light level. It's dark. And this is it. We are going. I'm amazed that these places are still open, actually. Surely that's shut. Surely these people waiting here. I want to grab some dinner, but where? It's 12:45 in the morning. What are you doing? And how come these things are open? How come the. You're supposed to be shut. What are you people doing? The things are pretty broken around here. Oh, is everyone. Is the lift broken? Ah! Oh, I see. Right, so the lift is broken and there is actually no alternative for people to get out. So those people, all the people on these floors are trapped. Captive audiences trapped until one of my lazy maintenance men comes along to mend the lift. Yeah, so these people milling about. Oh, got some buzz, did they? Brilliant. I'm glad they got some buzz out of that. Oh, I did do a thing about attracting more visitors from the city so they can come and look at the broken lifts. Oh, now it's broken in three different places. Brilliant. I'd quite like to speed time on until the lifts are mended. That would be ideal. Right, I think everyone's just going to go mad in a minute, but at least these places are going to make lots of money from essentially people starving to death. I don't understand why they're open at that time of day, but never mind. There we go. Is anyone going to come and mend the lift? Anyone? Can you... Maintenance men. Can you mend the lift? Something is broken. You need a maintenance office to fix it. I do have a maintenance office. They appear to be completely inept. I don't know what else it is that they are doing. Oh, now this bit's broke. Hang on. Hang on. This one lift shaft has got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 failures on it. What are the chances of that, given that... That... Hang on, that one's got... Have I got the world's worst lifts? Well, this column seems alright. This column seems tremendous. This is a beautiful lift shaft. That one is absolutely knackered. Don't move out. Don't move out. Right, I need to do this quickly now because people are complaining about lack of services. And yeah, look. They're saying, viruses, Trojans, broken screens, trash cans are full. Yeah, it's fine though, isn't it? But it's just going weird because your the numbers don't work. The math isn't right on it. Right, I'll drop your rent to zero and yours. Please don't move out. This is it. This is the symbolic end moment. Oh, these red angry faces down here are just the bins are full. So the bins are cross. Don't really understand, but someone does come and empty them periodically. Yeah, Anita. Yeah, the building does need maintenance, does it, Anita? And my maintenance people are... I don't know what they're doing. I don't know where they are, but... They're certainly not doing their jobs very bloody well. This floor looks horrendous. In fact, this whole floor. Hang on. The whole ground floor is dilapidated. Every single unit on the ground floor is run down. Yeah. I think I've ever seen that before. Every single... Oh, no. This place over here is fine. Richard and Bernard's luggage is excellent. Everything else is absolutely knackered. Okay, right, let's go to the top quick and finish, because I don't think this is going to work. I think people might move out. Okay, let's drop in the final bits of art. Let's do some medium art. Here's a weirdy picture. Yeah, so that can't go there. So I'm going to put it there. Can small art go in there then, or does that count as full? No, that counts as it being full. That's fine. And one there. Oh, is this it? No, I'm gonna have room for one. It's gonna be topped off with a piece of small art. And what better piece of small art than a picture of the naughty lady? Here we go, everyone. This is it. This is the end. This is the final bit of space in the tower full. There is no more room to put anything. Every single space in this whole thing is full, except for that one tiny bit at the top, which is going to have the picture of the naughty lady in it. So here we go. Here we go. Let's drop it in, and we can sit back and be finished. Are we ready? In goes the picture of the naughty lady. Yay, it's done! We have filled everything. We have filled in 15,000 tiles worth of stuff. So yes, our floor area is 15,000 tiles. We have used 15,000 tiles worth of stuff. Whether it's with lifts, bins, offices, ridiculous things like helicopter charter services, good old coffee shops, anything. Bits of art predominantly, and there's lots of them scattered around. That is it. It is finished. We have topped off the building, not quite as I planned, because I hadn't acknowledged that that big art had to go on the ground floor rather than any floor, which was a shame, because I thought it would look really good if you had that there, the big art picture there, and the big sculpture-y thing just there. I thought that would look rather good. But it is complete. And in come the hordes, in come the vast hordes of people who are, wow, there's an awful lot of people coming in to come and have a look at the new things. No one's in the actual top, you know, the observation deck yet. I assume that will attract attention at some point. I do like the way how people are clearly going out of their way to come to the gourmet rolls place or the Boulangerie de Paris, which it just seems a bit odd that they're going all that way to go, all right, some coffee. Good. It's very similar to the coffee I can get somewhere else, but lovely. There we go. Is that place turning a profit? Oh my goodness. Yes, it is. So yeah, we're done. We're finished. We have filled everything. It is done. My time with Project Highrise has come to an end for now, anyway. That was good. That was quite time-consuming, I'll be honest. There were certain bits of that. Uh-oh, I saw a red flag. Right, I'm pausing it because right now, we're good. I've completed it. This is ridiculous. The amount of people coming along here. Does through traffic affect how much it wears down? Maybe the amount of people passing through causes it to become mouldy. Because that would explain why that whole bit is really mangy. And the ground floor is really mangy as well. Also, worth noting, there isn't a janitor cupboard on that floor. A janitor closet thing. And I don't think there's one on the ground floor either. Which would explain why they are becoming a little bit more grim. But yeah, we don't need to worry about that now because we have finished. So yes, Project Highrise. I really rather enjoyed that. It scratched that itch. As soon as I saw it, I thought, oh no, I'm going to be playing this for hours. And behind the scenes, particularly the bits where you build massive sections of tower and then plummet in with the water and gas and electric and telephone and cable TV, which takes a long, long time to do. Far longer than you would have seen in any videos. So it's been a very time-consuming game. Not that it's been unpleasant. But yes, it certainly scratched that itch that I had. I didn't realise I had until I saw there was a tower sim game. And yeah, remembered all the way back to Sim Tower. Good old Sim Tower back in the day. So yeah, it's not without its flaws. It has some problems. Clearly there are some issues with things. It would be nice if there were more entertainment things for them to be able to do. There's no sort of fun things for them to do, like a cinema, or an arcade, or a bowling alley, or whatever, you know, sort of a entertainment sort of thing. There's, you know, shops and restaurants, which is fine, but yeah, there's nothing else. Whereas in, you know, in towers, they have like viewing galleries and all sorts of things. And I imagine some of those things might have been answered by the call of the modders, because I saw there were a few things in the Steam Workshop for this. But I didn't want to use them for this playthrough. I wanted to do it sort of neat, sort of vanilla, if you like. Just to see if it could be done with the base game. Because, yeah, it might have added a lot of other things which could, in my mind, they would have been perceived as cheating if I'd have had loads of extra bits to fill in the gaps, you know, if they'd have had little areas. I don't know what they would have had, but, you know, like the common areas, like that sort of thing. But different things to fill in the gaps. I think I would have considered it cheating. It would have been a sort of, it would have been a false victory rather than the victory we just took there, which was good. I think we did that. We did it properly. And yeah, there are other problems as well, particularly the service provisioning. Obviously, those numbers definitely do not add up with the services. The fact that if you build a restaurant somewhere really, really, really far away and a restaurant somewhere else really, really far away loses 12 of its regular customers, they start threatening to move out. And it's a bit, whoa, okay. I can't stop you because of the 3,500 people that are in this building, 12 people have gone to somewhere else for a bit and you're going to move out even though you pay no rent. Fair enough. Jolly good. Things like that seem to be a bit irritating. Also, the lifts are a little bit strange. There's no... you're moving out as well. Cheerio. Bye-bye. Let's do that. The lifts are a bit odd. The lifts don't really have any logic behind them, I don't think. Literally, people get on and then just get off at the floor they need. And yes, that's the point of a lift, I hear you crying. but there's no, they don't go onto the floors in between. So I remember in Sim Tower, people used to stand and wait, and you'd be like, oh gosh, this lift is too slow. And the lifts could only go up, they could only have a certain range, something like 15, I can't remember now, but 15 floors of range. Whereas these lifts can go all the way to the top of the building if you so wished. They could literally span, well, that one does. Those lifts go all the way to floor whatever that is, 50 something or other. So, yeah, you know, I suppose it's just changes. And would it have been less fun having to faff about trying to work out which floor needs a lift on it and different levels of lifts and trying to fit all that? Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, I've just seen something awful. These. Oh, well, I take it all back. Oh, no. This is a tragedy. Right, paintings. Paintings. Let's put paintings in. Paintings. Oh, no. I wasn't finished by a picture of the naughty lady. Do you know what? It still can be. It still can be finished by a picture of the naughty lady. Why didn't I see those when I was doing this? What was wrong with me? Right, let's drop all these in. Come on, the money. I don't care about the money. The money is irrelevant. Okay, that and then, yep, and yes. Okay, repeating this. The picture of a naughty lady. Yay. Oh, that's ruined it, hasn't it? That's weed on the bonfire. That's whittled on my chips. Ah. Oh, I was so confident that I'd seen everything, but I suppose I hadn't checked the apartment bit because I was so sure that they all fitted this nice pattern, and I'd completely forgotten there was a little gap just there. And obviously I'd considered it because I'd put wallpaper stuff in, so I'd obviously considered that I was going to do something with this and then just hadn't. Oh well, I apologize everyone, I apologize for the false hope that I offered, but I think now we're good. We're good. I think we're sorted again, he says. Now, absolutely paranoid that I haven't filled everything up. That was all full. I'm sure it's fine. I'm sure it's now absolutely tickety-boo. So yes, this has indeed... It's been good. I've enjoyed playing this. It's good. It has that nice, nerdy sort of attention to detail of, you know, all right, how many across can I fit? I can fit one, two of this type. I was one of them and a lift. Is that sufficient for the people? Are they going to be cross from walking, you know, really far? Do I need more lifts, less lifts? And, you know, putting the restaurants in. And I quite like the way it looks. I mean, the audio is a little bit weird. The fact that the people go and, uh-huh. And, I mean, I don't even know what that was. Carol sounded like she was in some sort of weird jiu-jitsu. Let's see what he sounds like. Yeah, I don't want to talk to you very much, Alfred. Oh, he's very unhappy. Sorry, Alfred. You, what do you sound like? Uh-huh. Yeah, okay. Dinner time, says Francis from the city. What do you sound like? Yeah, the less said about that, the better. So, yes, the audio's a little bit strange, but I suppose you don't need audio for a tower sim. And yeah, I like the visuals. Everything is relatively distinct, I think. You know which offices are what, so you can tell. I mean, guess there's not, when you zoom out, there's not much delineation between the office boundaries, I guess. But yeah, that wasn't a problem while I was playing. I think I'm just nitpicking there. I don't think it's a particular issue. So yes, it did cater to my sort of nerdy needs of liking everything to be exact and counting the number of tiles and working it out. Yeah, it's just a shame that I think a lot of pressure was put on these. A lot, and obviously they are incorrect. There is something wrong with how the service calls are calculated, which is a shame because I think that kind of soured it a bit. It always felt like you were fighting an uphill battle against them, which, yeah, it turned out I was, because the numbers are wrong. It's crunching the numbers incorrectly. But yeah, that's something that we can't deal with now, and I think we handled it alright anyway. Oh, look at it. These places are all absolutely falling apart. So yeah, Project Highrise. Feel everything. Mission accomplished. Unless someone can spot something where I've left a gap amidst my scrolling about, in which case, please tell me, and I shall go back and fill it in and put a little correction thing on saying, yeah, actually, yes, well done, eagle-eyed viewer. You spotted a gap just there. So I've gone and filled it in, and here is the correct version of the finished tower. So, yeah, I think we save it and we leave it there. The Penge Spire can stand kind of glorious. It's not the most elegant topped building, is it? I mean, it doesn't. It's a bit kind of all of a sudden. It's like, yes, angular. Oh, but pointy bit just sort of slapped on the top. If I'd have known, I kind of would have graduated it to a point. But alas, I didn't know. I thought the 15,000 squares was enough to make a giant, basically a giant rectangle. And I was expecting to have to fill in all that stuff. Which I suppose in a way is quite good that I didn't have to fill it all in, because it would have been filled with services, let's be honest, or else everyone would be just moving out and causing all sorts of trouble. So, yes, the Penge Spire. Oh, I'm looking, it's coming up to night time now. There we go, the Penge Spire at night time. Standing proud in whatever city it's supposed to be in. Let's say it's in Barnsley. The mighty... Oh no, it's American, isn't it? Where's an American city that's not really, really, really famous? I don't know. There must be a Barnsley. I bet there's a Barnsley in America. Yeah, right, it's in Barnsley, America, in Wisconsin or something. I don't know. I'm making this up. Can you tell? So yes, it stands. I think it stands proud. I think it's good. I like the Penge Spire. It's good. It has thought. It's got thought and care applied to it, which is kind of what I wanted. I didn't just want to go, any old tut. There were some elements of that of going, right, yeah, fill it in with a bit of art. But at least it's art. At least I've not just gone, yeah, just wallpaper it and put a pot plant there. Because you can do that. These things are here. You can put in regular things. Where is it? It's in here, isn't it? Yes, there you go. Furniture. You know, you can put in a modernist black chair and they're all free. And a dark brown cabinet with drawers and lights and boring things. A water dispenser and all that kind of stuff. But I didn't really want to do that. And Halloween things. I didn't want to do that. I wanted to do it properly. As though it had a bit of something to it. A bit of, I don't know, character? Is that the right word? I don't know. I'm kind of waffling now, aren't I? A bit. But yeah, I just wanted to do it properly, I think. Rather than just doing it haphazard. I wanted to do it properly and well. And maybe well is arguable. I think I did it properly. I think I've done a good job. And we have accomplished something here. No one will write home about it, I'm quite sure. But I think this is good. And so now I think it's time we bid adieu, we bid farewell to the Penge Spire. We've set out what we wanted to achieve. Mission accomplished. We can now leave it in the hands of the digital gods, and we can just pretend it carries on its little day-to-day business, and no one leaves, everyone's happy. As soon as we leave this, everybody is happy. And nobody will ever leave. It's like the Hotel California, but a spire-y type thing, but office workers. It's not like the Hotel California at all. I don't know why I even said that. So, thank you for joining me on this little journey. I hope it was entertaining. I think it was. There were some good bits. I'm sure there were some tedious bits as well. Watching me wire things in is probably not the highlight of anybody's YouTube viewing experience, but still it needed to be done, and I hopefully cut out the majority of the dullest of the wiring bits. So thank you for accompanying me on this journey, and thank you for joining me in the Geek Cupboard, and I will see you next time. This is never going to end well if it's just me having to use my own wits and skill to survive. Lovely heater, my friend the heater. Beer, drink, can I just get leathered? That'll make me warm. Getting warm, nice and warm, jolly good. Yes, like a drunk man trying to find his way to the bar. I don't know what I'm doing. I can play darts. 340. Is that right? Something like that. You've took on my monster munch. Where's all the monster munch?